Alright. So, get ready on that timer. It's after this 2.5 minute cutscene, so you have plenty of time.
Have I ever told you about my son?
This is Ratchet. Cracking time,
remarkable boy.
It's a video game.
Quite smart. He was born in a robot factory in the Solana galaxy. But to be precise, he was created much farther away. My son's name is XJ0461, but the universe knows him as Clank.
The Zoni are inquiring about our progress.
So the only thing I really should say about this game is that yesterday I did a marathon run of this, and I got world record accidentally. So now I'm gonna try to get a better run.
Yes, I'm fixing!
That's
stand
it.
By for sister board scan.
Alright, let's see. Favorite color's green, favorite number's 83 billion and 4.7, blah blah blah.
Access denied. Neural safeguard activated.
No. Oh, okay.
No.
Yeah, I,
locked out again.
I think I turned down the,
somewhere in this brain lies the key to the Orbis chamber.
No, Orbis chamber.
When I,
your zoniness. If we could take but a peek at the chamber.
No, Orbis chamber. Chamber is for sire only.
Very well.
Because with this game audio, the only way people will hear me is if I yell into the mic, which is bad.
Say hello to...
Not the hypersonic brainwave scrambler.
The hypersonic brainwave scrambler!
Apology, sir. I should have mentioned.
No, I'm at level max volume right now. But I will turn the game down. Hey, Sharpstick, thanks.
Stop him!
Alright, so get ready on that timer, by the way. I'm gonna pause as soon as possible here to turn on the game audio. Oh, that's why. Like. The game audio automatically goes to default, which is super loud. Alright, so you're ready to start that timer, by the way. Alright. 3, 2, 1, go. Alright, so hopefully the game shouldn't be louder than me right now. Is the game actually, like, louder than me? Alright, good. So, Ratchet, it's a video game. And I'm gonna play it. This first level, there's really nothing much to it. I just do some basic movement with Clank. And pick up bullets along the way. But it doesn't really matter that much. So right here, I have to test some camera or whatever. I don't really pay attention much to video games, so... So as I said before, but the cutscene audio drowned me out, yesterday I did a marathon run of this at the Super Dog Fawn, and I accidentally got the any percent world record in that run, and that run was actually really sloppy, and so I'm gonna try to get a better time here. If I end up failing, then I'm gonna blame Milk. That's alright. So, optimizing this Clank movement is actually pretty hard. There are lots of little nuances that you have to pay attention to. And there is actually one kind of difficult trick with Clank coming up. That I'm gonna try to not fuck up, but if I do, then it's no big deal, I guess. Thanks, Rick. Okay, so this jump here is stupid because these robots like to shoot at me, and if they do, then that can fuck me over, but thankfully that didn't happen. If those robots hit me in midair, I can either fall down instantly to my death, or the shot's knockback is only gonna happen when I grab onto a ledge. So I'm gonna be dead either way, but just something to note. And of course, my nose starts to itch right now, because why not? So it actually doesn't matter how many bolts I pick up here as Clank, because I'm gonna spawn in with Ratchet on the next planet with 1,000 bolts either way. Alright. That's the first Clank level done, and that's actually the one of two times we'll actually play as Clank in the entire game. We'll only play as him again at the very end. During the game, there are Clank levels normally throughout the entire game, but we're gonna skip all of those with a trick. So, right here is a small, like, minute and a half cutscene before the next level. This game has a lot of unskippable cutscenes, unfortunately. But whatever, it makes for like a good bathroom break.
I am curious, what lie did you tell the Zoni in your quest for vengeance?
Vengeance? You think I went to all this trouble for mere vengeance? They say I make a maniacal. Let's just say it's all in the past.
Lawrence!
Right here, sir.
Ready the orb of gratuitous immobilization.
So the next planet is Zolar Forest. And it's actually a kind of difficult planet for a lot of reasons. But hopefully I should be good.
No, I have a better idea.
Because there's a few tricks that can screw me over. One near the end and one kind of at the very start. Right, so now we're in Zolar Forest with Captain Quark, and Captain Quark is actually one of the things that can waste time in this level, because he constantly runs along in front of you, but he gets scared of all the enemies in the path, so you have to kill them before, like, you have to kill all the enemies so that he doesn't, like, get scared, I guess. But the thing is, this first horde of mushrooms right here at the start, you actually have to kill most of them, otherwise Captain Quark's just gonna keep shooting them. And it's gonna take like 5 million years for him to kill them all. So you gotta keep moving and kill all of them without like Captain Quark stopping. If you don't kill as many as you need to, there Captain Quark is gonna keep shooting. And instead of being at the bridge here instantly, so you gotta keep that in mind so you don't waste time. So during this run, I'm also gonna try to collect a lot of bolts because I need bolts to buy weapons. In a moment I'm actually gonna buy like my first weapon, and it's gonna be a weapon that I use like throughout pretty much 80% of the run. It's the bomb glove, and it's really overpowered despite being like such a like simple gun that you get at the very beginning of the game. We use it for a lot of things. So yeah, Captain Quark gets scared of mushrooms because he's an idiot. And now I'm gonna walk through this water here and do a very small skip. Does this run include glitches? No, actually. Well, of course it does. Like, seriously. I'm gonna skip everything I can. And some of the skips are actually pretty hard. I don't want any spoilers. This game literally doesn't have any spoilers for Ratchet and Clank 1. Like, that doesn't... Right. So I buy the bomb glove there, And now I'm gonna try to level it up a little bit. Oops, I accidentally shot it. So I gotta kill these mushrooms here to gain a little bit of experience to it. And now is a pretty difficult trick. I have to save these three little kids. And saving this first one early is kind of a difficult thing. Have to ledge grab onto that, jump here, and now I gotta do kind of a tricky jump to this pillar. And, please, okay, good, I got it. So, all that does is it saves going around and doing a lot of platforming, and it saves, I think, like 40 or 50 seconds worth of walking. This game has no spoilers. I mean, this game does have spoilers for itself. If you don't want the story of this game to be spoiled, then you shouldn't be watching this. But, alright. So that's bad RNG right there. The mushrooms are not close together at all, so I couldn't blow them up with one bomb glove. Oh, come on, really? That mushroom didn't die. Did you say Super Mario 64 having spoilers? Okay, so I only have one bomb glove shot right now because I wasted that ammo. So I don't know if I'm gonna be able to kill these guys. Princess is in another castle. Yeah, Bowser kidnaps the princess. Sorry for the spoilers, by the way. Thanks for the good luck. Alright, so before we move on to the next part of Zolar, let's just appreciate the glorious Quark booty right here. So now that we've done with the Quark booty appreciation, we're gonna try to jump on Quark's head. For no real reason other because I'm bored. Dang, I didn't get it. Right. Ah, I didn't even land on Quark's head. Yeah, this run is now invalid, sorry guys. So this first two horde of mushrooms here, you don't actually have to kill any of them. Captain Quark and the others are just gonna run past them, but this last one you do have to kill all of them. And it's kind of annoying since you don't have like any weapons at all, you have to do this all with the bomb glove. So I'm taking out these enemy spawners first, before taking out everything else. Okay, so, alright, yeah, okay, everything is dead. Now the chief's gonna open the door for me. That was actually kind of a good fight for those mushrooms. So now we're in the village here. And nobody really cares about these villagers, so I'm just physically assaulting them just because I can. So I'm gonna enter the Temple of Zaun, and the Temple of Zaun actually has some stuff to it. There's some small door optimization, and there's also a trick that is kind of hard, but then I'll explain it when I get to it. So I have to listen to this asshole talking. I can't skip it or whatever. I just have to listen to him talking so I can progress with the game. I'm gonna type in chat just because I can. And now we're gonna enter the temple here. And must be kept together for their energy to work. Inside is a vessel which will allow you to rescue Lost Zoni and harness their bioenergy. Follow me and don't touch anything. So I have to kinda listen for some audio cues here to know when the guy's lowering the door. So I can do like that. I can double jump super early and I stand on top of the door that's coming down, and so I can run and immediately get to it. So again, I have to sort of wait here, so I'll do contemplating because why not. So I have to listen for this audio cue here of the guy opening the door. That's alright, I didn't like get the door strat. Got hit there, that normally doesn't happen. Okay. So now this is the anybody who's played Ratchet and Clank Up Your Arsenal will, like, this looks kind of like the Path of Death from that game, only extremely toned down. Right. So now I'm gonna do a trick. I'm gonna do it and then I'm gonna explain what it is. But there are two Zoni in this area right here, one on the ground and one in the air. I'm normally supposed to get the one on the ground first, and then the one in the air will go through the temple, and then I get him. But I can do this and get the one in the air first, and because he's supposed to be the second one that only appears later in the temple, as soon as I get him, I get teleported to where he normally is. So that just saves a ton of walking. That also means we're gonna leave Zolar of only two Zoni instead of the intended three. But it's alright, because we're not gonna collect much Zoni anyways. So now, Vorsalon attacks this planet or whatever, and now we gotta fight a bunch of these robots with only our bomb glove. And it's kind of annoying because the robots cannot get hit for some reason. Alright, that was good. So this UFO drops off these two robots. I'm gonna kill all of them. Come on, really? Great. This is kind of a okay robot fight so far. Alright. That's kind of good. So, these guys are gonna get kidnapped, and then I'm gonna use my wrench to kill these guys in the air, because my bomb glove doesn't reach. And I have to make sure all of these robots are dead, otherwise the chief guy isn't gonna follow me. Right here's the second part of this fight. These tiny robots here, I gotta make sure all of them are dead. Otherwise, the chief is also gonna like stall behind. Alright, this part is annoying. These guys coming down here, they can screw you over if you're not careful. Alright, that was alright. Oh, come on. One guy's still alive. Okay, no, he isn't. So now this UFO is gonna go and drop this big guy. And it's actually possible to destroy this UFO before this big guy spawns. But it's extremely difficult and not worth doing, in my opinion anyways. I don't like going for it because it's like, it doesn't save that much time and it actually ends up wasting ammo and may or may not screw you over later in the first, in the next planet because of having to look for ammo. Oh, come on, really? So we're gonna leave Zolar with only two Zoni instead of the three that the game normally intends you to get. So that's cool, I guess. Oh, do I actually have my FFZ here? I do. That's interesting. So now the next level is Vorsalon's ship, and Vorsalon's ship is really reset heavy because of three things. The ships outside, which are RNG, the door clip, which is extremely hard and random, and Vorsalon himself, which likes to screw you over. So hopefully I get a good Vorsalon, but I don't know. So now we're in space, and barrel rolling sideways like this is faster when you're going in space, but it's not too much faster, but it is like time save. So now I gotta defeat 25 of these ships, and that is harder than it sounds, because one, your ship is extremely slow, and two, these ships like to move in like really erratic ways. Alright, this is kind of a good RNG. They're all like really close to me. Alright, I got Kaboom, which is a RNG power-up there along with double damage. And I need to get these power-ups because they're really useful. They're RNG, which ones you get, so a lot of the times you have to kind of rely on luck to get good ships. But otherwise, it's normally not that bad. So now we're into Vorsalon's ship proper. And Vorsalon's ship is, it's pretty annoying for a multitude of reasons. So we just walk through this fire because we're badass like that. Then instead of pulling this bridge down, we just go down here and double jump. And now, we pull this thing out because otherwise the fire would damage us too much before we are able to jump over here. And now we're gonna enter the ship. In the ship, you're gonna see some examples of tricks that we're gonna be using later on in the run. Mainly hyperstrike abusing and jumping on top of enemies to clip through things, which you're gonna see all later on, especially hyperstrike abusing. Okay, so I kinda got of a kind of a bad laser cycle here. Normally that laser is not too far to the right. How you're playing and typing at the same time? Loading screens. Shoutouts to those. Alright. So, what I was talking about, the hyperstrike. Basically, when you jump and attack with your wrench, he does this like downward slam attack. And when that happens, you get a little bit more distance and a little bit more height. And that height is just like barely enough so that you can do a lot of cool stuff with it. A lot of cool skips and unintended stuff. Ratchet and Clank, any world record .mp4. Dude, shoutouts to that run yesterday. I got world record while I had a stream picnic. So, yeah. Literally spliced. So now you're gonna see the very first example of abusing the hyperstrike to our advantage. And basically you're supposed to do a bunch of fighting stuff here, but I can just double jump and slam. And as you can see there, I gained a little bit of extra height, and that was enough to give me up to that to this area over here a little bit earlier than intended. So now is a really annoying trick. It's called door clip. And door clip is stupid, to say the least. That's just the one way I can actually like describe it. It's just dumb and bad. So I'm gonna do it, and then I'm gonna explain it later, because it's kind of a retarded trick to do while explaining it. Shit. Oh no. Oh, come on, please. No, please. No, okay. Jesus Christ. No, okay. Oh my god. No! Fuck! Okay, so that's already... World record is dead. Fuck this game. So, what I was trying to do there is I was trying to manipulate the enemies so that I can stand on top of one of them and then jump onto the sliding door so I can clip through it and skip straight to the boss. But because I'm shit at this video game, that ended up not happening, so that's cool, I guess. Okay, that's... I left way too many guys alive, so they just ended up, like, destroying me. Oh, come on. Okay, that's how you do it. Yeah, world record is dead. Actually, world record might not be dead, but... yeah, it's unlikely. Because my world record yesterday actually had quite a lot of mistakes. So it's not exactly something I'm proud of. So this guy right here is Vorsalon. His boss fight is pretty annoying. I'm gonna try to manipulate so that my bomb glove gets to level 3 while I'm fighting him, which happened, which is pretty cool. And the reason for that is so I don't have to keep looking for ammo while I'm fighting him. Where the fuck is he? I lost him. Okay. So he likes to turn invisible a lot, which is super dumb. But whatever. Oh wait, oh god, really? Okay. So I'm gonna actually get a health upgrade while I'm fighting him. And the health upgrade actually does damage to him because it's like this huge flashbang explosion thing. And it actually does a lot of damage to bosses. So it's kind of like routed out so that you get a health upgrade and a V-free upgrade while you're fighting Vorsalon. So that actually speeds up the fight a lot. So compared to my run yesterday, that was actually a really good Vorselon fight. I got the V3 upgrade and the health kill at the same time, but I also like died on door clip, so that might not have been as good as it seemed. But whatever, I'll keep going. So now I'm gonna skip the Clank level, and the reason we do that is because the Clank levels are slow, really boring puzzle shit. So instead, what we're gonna do is we're gonna abuse this menuing trick right here to completely ignore them. So Ratchet and Clank are actually separated throughout most of the game. So you do the first level of Clank, then the first sector of Ratchet, second sector of Clank, second sector of Ratchet and stuff. And normally that's how the game goes, but we can skip that. If we land on this planet... Okay, so I'm gonna do it and then I'm gonna explain it afterwards. Right. So I landed on that planet, and I pressed the galaxy map at the same time. So I warped to the next sector, which plays this Clank cutscene. The game is like, oh, you're leaving this sector, therefore you're already like, you're gonna start the Clank level. Let's play this cutscene. But because I landed on the planet before I did that, the game is like, oh, you landed on the planet, let's just bring you to that planet then. So I land on the planet, and then I exit the planet, and re-warp to the same sector I just warped to, and the game is like, oh, okay, so you're entering this sector. That clearly means you've already beaten the Clank level. So yeah, you already beat the Clank level, just go to the next sector. And so we can effectively skip all the Clank levels by doing that. And this is like pretty much just an intermission. We do this 3 times throughout the run, and it's really just an intermission because it's nothing like... It's just 5 minutes of nothing but cutscenes and loading screens to skip the Clank level. So if you like want to go to the bathroom, or like get some water or make a sandwich or something, this is like the perfect time, because you're literally not going to miss anything. Technically, I could go and take a shit right now and I wouldn't even like change the run at all. But I'm not going to do that because I love you guys. So then we exit the planet, and then rewarp and play the cutscene. What a nice guy. Right. Oh, oops. And these Clank skips, they only work on the very first planet. If you try to do them on any other planet, it's not gonna work. Because the Phylax sector is actually the only, like, sector that you can actually do it in, because it's so small that it deloads fast enough so that we can skip the warping animation. If you try to do it on anywhere else, it's just not gonna work. Yeah, shoutouts to the unskippable cutscenes in this game. But they're actually pretty funny, honestly. Actually, this one is great.
I don't have the capacity for love, Janice. I was cursed by a tribe of gypsy ninjas when I was a kid.
I know, Lan. I was in that tribe of gypsy ninjas.
In the meantime,
suggest engaging with safety so as not to kill any more troops.
It's not even loaded, you moron! Look!
Yeah, when he gets angry, he like shorts out, and it starts playing a soap opera called Lance and Janice, and it's literally the best show in the galaxy. Yeah, Lance is not capable for love, because he was cursed by a tribe of gypsy ninjas when I was a kid. And Janice was actually part of that tribe of gypsy ninjas, so it's all good. Oh, I don't know. Whatever. So, the next planet here is Malanoff. And Malanoff is actually pretty interesting, because most planets usually have, like, this huge skip that just completely skips a ton of stuff. But Malanoff actually just has a bunch of small time savers, one after another, all in a row. And Malanoff is actually where we get the hover boots. And if you're familiar with Ratchet 2 and 3, you'll know that the charge boots in those games are used to skip quite a lot of stuff. And that's the same with this game. We use the charge boots to skip a lot of stuff that you're normally not supposed to. So right there, I jump on top of that pipe to ledge grab up here and get to here a little bit earlier instead of going around. So right here, I'm going to kill these enemies in sort of a weird way with my wrench. And you might be asking, like, why aren't you using your weapons here? And it's because I actually want this lamppost to my right to remain completely intact. If I use my bomb there, that lamppost is actually going to explode, and I need it to do a skip, to skip this grind rail section right here, actually. Oh, oops, I pulled down the thing. Where's the Zoni? Alright, so I failed getting that Zoni there, that's no problem. So yeah, that's the third Zoni we get, and we're actually only going to get 6 Zoni in the game. Casually, you're intended to get at least, like, 21 of them, I think. But we're not gonna do that because of some skips later on. So I need that lamppost to do that jump here and skip some grind rails. So this guy's just gonna keep talking until he opens the door. So this is like an opportunity for me to get extra bolts. Because in the next planet, we're gonna be buying our new weapon anyways. So it might as well just get bolts here because you can't speed this section up at all. Zoni are like those little, like, alien bug things that I have to collect. They upgrade your ship. Like, the more Zoni you get, the better your ship gets. And I'm only gonna get 6 of them because it gives my ship, like, this speed booster, and it makes it go much faster in space. So it just ends up being worth it to grab 6 Zoni along the way. We don't actually need any of the upgrades past the speed booster, so that's why we only get 6 of them. And the reason for that is because some planets have barriers around them that normally prevent you from getting past it without a certain upgrade, but there are ways to skip past them. So I just entered the holo right here, and I'm gonna skip all of the holo by doing this trick, if I can actually get it, that is. So I do a sideways ledge grab here, which allows me to get out of bounds here. Like, I'm out of bounds, I'm not supposed to be over here. And then jump around there. And then I just immediately jump all the way over to the end of this holo. And that skips having to do a bunch of stupid stuff with the battery bots. That normally takes a while. But it's all good. So, now I have to kill these robots right here. I have full ammo, that's good. Oh, oops, I missed my mom move. Oh, come on, really? I'm gonna try to do something here. Okay, come on, please. Nope, I didn't get it. Alright, so what I was trying to do there is, if I press some very specific inputs before the black, in the black screen before this grind rail section right here, it's actually possible for you to go glitch the grind rail and go at double speed. But the thing is, it's an extremely rare, difficult glitch, and it might as well be luck-based, because the previous world record holder for any percent, Lombax999, he's only gotten this trick 4 times ever, and one of those times was doing his any percent PB. So his PB was really hard to beat for a long while, just because he got fast rails, and it's a trick that literally, like, it's a 1 in a million chance, pretty much. You're never really gonna get it unless you're intentionally trying to figure out how it works, which we don't even know how it works yet. We just press a bunch of random buttons and hope it works. So fast rails actually saves, I think, 15 or 20 seconds in this grind rail section right here. But it's extremely difficult, so like all my splits don't even have fast rails to account for. So this guy we're chasing right here is Azimuth. He's a Lombax, like Ratchet. And normally throughout the game's story, he's supposed to be like your father figure, your mentor. He helps you along the way. But in the speedrun, we're just gonna continually screw him over throughout the entire game, because we're nice guys like that. So he gives us the hover boots here. And now we're gonna skip all of the hover boot course by doing some clever trickery with them right here. So we're gonna abuse this conveniently placed lamp on the wall here, and then jump over this barrier that normally prevents us from getting here. Hold on. I feel like someone's knocking on the door. Am I seriously gonna have to pause my run to go answer the door? I think I will. Okay. God damn it. Alright, who cares? Let's just continue. So, that actually doesn't matter that I paused my game there, because the community actually uses in-game time as opposed to real time. And the reason for that is because in-game time doesn't count menus, loading screens, and cutscenes. So it's just extremely more reliable and useful than real time. So that's why we use it. So that pause actually didn't theoretically cost me any time, in-game time anyways. So here we get a skill point for no reason, and now we're gonna get the Zony. So this is the fourth Zony that we're gonna get. And after this is Axiom City. And this is gonna be the first example of a barrier skip. There's normally a barrier around this planet that you normally need the ship booster upgrade to get through. But we're actually just gonna go out of bounds in space and skip having to do that, because we're really cool like that. So that's why we only need 6 Zony, because all the other upgrades required to get past the planetary barriers, we don't actually need them. Yeah, so now we get the upgrade that we were supposed to get 2 planets earlier, but now we're just gonna do Axiom. Yo, Tarna, what's up? Tarna is a really cool Ratchet runner too. He runs Up Your Arsenal, and that game is a really cool speed game. You should definitely give it a watch. So now we're gonna do the Axiom City barrier skip. And this skip is harder than it looks, by the way. Especially this first one. This first barrier skip is actually the hardest one out of the 3 in the game, because the things around the planet right here are really, like, finicky, and they like to screw you over a lot. Okay, so need to make sure I'm in somewhat of a good position. Yeah, I think I'm far enough away from the satellites. Right. So we are going out of bounds in space right here. We're past the wall that normally blocks us. So we're not supposed to be, like, I'm not supposed to be all the way over here. Like, the game doesn't know what to do, so it just kind of lets me do this. And now, these are the satellites that normally push me away when I try to get close to the planet. I'm gonna be kind of safe here. Ah, oh, are you kidding me? God damn it. Okay, so that happens once in a while. Like, I was, like, too close, I think. And so, when I try to go left, which is what normally puts me past this barrier right here, it just ended up, like, not even putting me past the barrier. I was just barely close enough. Right. Hopefully this should be good. Okay, it is. So that's an example of a barrier skip going wrong. Normally that doesn't happen, but when it does, it's quite a bit of a time loss. But whatever, I don't really care about that. Actually, I care immensely, but let's not just say that. So when I enter Axiom City right here, I'm gonna buy the best weapon in the game, Mr. Zircon. Mr. Zircon is just this little robot that flies around with you and shoots shit. And so he's gonna be extremely useful throughout the entire run. So we just buy him here. We could technically buy him in Malanoth, but it's not, like, faster to buy him there instead of just buying him here, because the vendor right here is just, like, on the path. Oh, come on, really? Am I seriously gonna miss this Zony? Oh my god. Okay, so I'm fucking retarded, and I missed the Zony. So now I just gotta kill myself and try again, because otherwise that Zony is just gonna go all the way, and it's gonna waste just a ton of time. It's really dumb. So whatever, that's not too big of a time loss. So that's the fifth Zony. Second to last one. And now we're just gonna go through the rest of the level. Till we get to the spaceport. So now that we're at the spaceport right here, we can do this small skip. We can jump on this couch and then hyperstrike up there to get up to that platform a little bit early. Now I'm gonna pull out Mr. Zircon and the bomb glove because he really speeds up this fight coming up. All these robots here, Mr. Zircon really like fucks them up good. So my bomb glove ends up getting to level 4 here, which is a good thing. So Mr. Zircon really speeds up that fight. It may not seem like it, but he does. So I'm gonna grab this battery bot here to open the gate. That leads me to the sixth and last Zony that I'm ever gonna get in the entire game. We don't need any more Zony other than this one. Okay. That's the last Zony in the game. And now, we're just gonna go through. Oh, oops. Okay, so I missed a cycle there. That's not too big of a deal. But I just, I was planning on going full YOLO and just going for that, but I would've died. So that's why I backed up a little bit. So Azimuth wants our help here, because he's fighting all these robots by himself. So, like, he really doesn't stand a chance. But instead of helping him, we're actually just gonna skip doing a bunch of this fighting. By jumping on top of that monitor, okay. That's the first part done. Then, we're gonna do this. And then hopefully I don't fuck this up. Okay, good. Then we're gonna climb this sign here. And then, we're gonna climb the rest of this. Oh no! Jesus Christ, that gave me a heart attack, holy shit. So, if I fall off of here, I'm pretty much dead. I either softlock or I die, and that wastes us a ton of time. So we just jump from there, glide over here to this ramp, align ourselves, and now we're in Pollux Industries without all the fighting. So we just got into Pollux Industries, and now we're gonna skip all of Pollux Industries, because why not? So we just jump across this wall, let's grab that. Let's grab these pipes on the ceiling here. And now we're above Pollux Industries, and conveniently, we can just jump to the end. Yeah, instead of helping Asimov, we just skip a bunch of shit he asks us to do. That's gonna be a constant throughout the entire run. We're never gonna do anything Asimov says. So now we gotta fight this huge robot guy, and this is actually one of the most boring parts of the run, in my opinion, fighting this huge robot. So this is one of the areas that Mr. Zircon kinda helps out. You can focus on one robot while Mr. Zircon shoots the other, and it'll save a bit of time. Actually, I don't even need Mr. Zircon by this point. So right here is literally just waiting for a full minute, I think, for this robot guy to catch up. And when this robot guy catches up, we're gonna jump on top of him, Shadow of the Colossus style, and we're gonna fuck him up. But even then, when we're like climbing on him, it's just dreadfully boring. This seems like somewhat entertaining, but what you actually don't know is that you are hearing the game audio, I am not. I'm playing this in like full silence right now. So, yeah, this is more boring than it seems for me, actually, because I'm not hearing anything. So there's not even like game audio or sound effects to keep me entertained. Alright, now we're gonna jump on him. And now, we literally just do nothing right here. For a bit. Then we just dodge lasers and turn bolt cranks for like 2 minutes. It's dumb. And hey, has to be done, otherwise you can't beat the game. Right. Turn this first one, and then we just do that twice more. And then this boss is somewhat dead. So if you want to like plug the Degenerate Homos Discord or something, or read first time donator shit, just go right ahead. You can quote Feshpence too if you're bored. Yeah, greetings from Germany, long time watcher, first time donator. My mom has Ebola. Please, save the animals. I'm actually not gonna save the animals because I do end up killing a lot of animals in this game, so that's alright. Alright, so we just killed this boss, and right here I'm actually gonna kill myself. I'm actually gonna jump in this pit and die. And I have to do this on purpose, because if I don't die right here, I'm gonna do a skip to like get onto the boss, right? But if I don't die right here, the boss is actually gonna be invincible, and it's gonna be impossible for me to beat him. So that's why I need to jump down there, because otherwise the boss is literally gonna be unbeatable. This lamppost slope intercept is annoying. Didn't get it. Right, that's alright. It usually takes like a few tries. Okay. That was bad. Oh, come on. Seriously. So this is harder than it looks, by the way. Alright, good. So now we just climb up this invisible slope right here. Jump on this ledge. And now we're gonna jump straight to the boss. Here. And this is where Mr. Zircon kind of comes in handy. So, these generator things around this boss, if I didn't jump down there and kill myself, then they would literally not explode right here. No matter how many bombs I threw at them, they would just not break. So that's why I actually just died right there. So now we gotta fight this boss with the Bomb Glove and Mr. Zircon. It's pretty easy. You just kind of circle around him and spam. Oh, oops. Oops, this is our gun. Exploded. Alright, good. So that's Axiom City. That was kind of a bad Axiom City, actually, but that's alright. So now we're gonna do another clank skip, another 5-minute intermission of loading screens and cutscenes, and then we're gonna move on to Corfos. And Corfos sector is actually it's a pretty interesting sector. It has 4 planets, and 3 of them are really hard, and 1 of them is kinda weird. And it's probably one of the most stressful parts in the entire game, I'd say. In my opinion, anyways. Yeah, Tarna, the bomb glove, like, really destroys this game. Like, it's the weapon that we use pretty much the entire game. Except at the very end when we buy, the buzz blades. The buzz blades are really, really powerful when you get them. So now we have 6 Zoni, and now we have the ship booster. And as you can see, my ship moves a lot faster in space now. So that's why we get the 6 Zoni before this, because the ship just moves like incredibly fast. Alright. The shock cannon from Muya? Yeah, kinda. Except we don't even like get a shotgun weapon in this game. I mean, you do, but we don't actually buy it in the run. Fun fact, this run finishes the game with literally only 6 weapons, and we only actually buy 4 of them. One of them is the pistol, which you have by default when you start the game, and the other one is, the negotiator, which you get for completing the battle arena anyways. So we only really buy, like, 4 weapons the entire game, which is pretty cool. So, throughout most of the game, we're extremely underpowered to deal with bosses and enemies and stuff. But thankfully, there are a lot of ways to skip combat, so... most of the time, that stuff doesn't matter. Shout out to these Valkyries right here. Again, there's really not much to say here. If you want to go to the bathroom, then this is like the perfect time. You're not gonna miss absolutely anything.
Mind the clock while I'm gone. Wind the time cleaners and let's just keep this our little secret as the kids.
Alright, so now we gotta fight Libra in space. And because our ship is so massively underpowered, this battle is kind of annoying. The reason for that is because I have to rely a lot on power-up RNG. Because I need two power-ups, primarily. Rapid fire and double damage. And whether or not I get those is completely up to luck. So you can easily lose a ton of time here if you get bad RNG, or if you just like get bad ship patterns or whatever. So it's kind of annoying. In New Game Plus, you don't have to worry about it too much because your ship is like super overpowered in that category. Since, you know, it's New Game Plus, you already have everything. But in New Game, you only have... Okay, good. So I got the double damage power up right there. That's one of the things that I wanted. So I just could destroy Libra like instantly, as you saw there. And immediately move on to the next phase. And because of that, I can also kill these ships a bit faster too. Okay, the power up ran out. That's alright. Come on, really. Black guy. Okay, so that's the other power up that I wanted, which is rapid fire. It's really useful. So it completely massacres Libra here at the very end. Okay, that's good. I got rapid fire and double damage at the same time. That's ideally what should happen, so that I can kill Libra and the ships as fast as possible. I think that was a pretty good Libra fight. I got some pretty decent power-up luck. The other power-ups that you can get in a ship fight are Kaboom, which only works or which only helps at the first Vorsalon ship, where you have to destroy all the 25 ships before you land there, so you can kill all the ships next to you with Kaboom. Or the other power-up, which is double bolts. It doesn't actually like help at all, obviously, because you don't really need bolts. Clipping out of bounds to ship a thing? Yeah, we clip out of bounds in space with the ship to skip the planet barriers. You're actually going to see that two planets from now, when I get to Tombly Outpost, I'm going to be doing that again. So Crow Cannon here, we're going to pretty much do the entire planet backwards. So we're going to jump into this corner right here to activate a cutscene early, and now that pretty much breaks open the planet already, because we're going to do a lot of stuff completely out of order. We're not supposed to be, like, doing the stuff I'm doing right here. So normally we're supposed to, here, fight a bunch of guys, but again, nobody really cares about that, so I'm just going to skip it by climbing these metal things right here, and then hopefully... Oh, oops, I missed it. Come on. Oh, really? Okay. I can. Don't seem to be getting this much grab right here. Okay, great. Yeah, sure, game. Come on, am I seriously choking here? Like, Crow Cannon of all things? Okay, good. First try is shit, but whatever. So now I'm above the level, and now I'm at the end of the level. Inbounds again. So now I'm at the end, in this cave, where you're normally supposed to have the Omni Soaker. I'm gonna activate this checkpoint right here. Then I'm gonna go to the other side and get killed by these bugs here. The Tetramites. And then I'm gonna respawn with Azimuth with me. And then I'm gonna finish the level. Technically, I'm gonna get to the end of this cave again and finish the level. So now Azimuth is here. And now we just go to the end. So now we've technically finished the level. The game is like, oh, you've activated this cutscene, therefore, like, the level is over, right? But I could technically leave right now, actually. But I will not, because all that shit that I just did, it skipped the Omni Soaker. And I'm actually gonna need the Omni Soaker later in the run. So that's why we have to go back here and backtrack to get it. So the way to get the Omni Soaker is to listen to this guy's dialogue. Some Vuller guy starts talking to you, and then when he ends his dialogue, he gives you the Omni Soaker. So, like, we just have to wait around here. So it's kind of a good opportunity to get more bolts. So yeah, we just sort of stand around here and hear this guy talk. So yeah, now we have the Omni Soaker, which we need. It's a necessary gadget to progress in the game. So thankfully, because we did all that stuff, the guy doesn't actually close the entrance to the cave there. So we can just easily go out and back to our ship easily. Crow Canyon is easily, I think, the most broken planet in the game. We just never do anything in it. That planet is normally a lot longer, casually, if you're playing this. There's a lot more stuff to it. But if you do it properly in a speedrun, you just see pretty much nothing. So, the next level is the Battleplex, and it's the Battle Arena level in this game. And this is one of the main reasons why we buy Mr. Zircon, because he really speeds up this Battle Arena. We have to, in the story, we're here to save Captain Quark, because Quark gets kidnapped, and we have to save him by doing these, like, arena challenges. And this is the primary reason why we buy Mr. Zircon. Like, if we didn't have Mr. Zircon here, like, each challenge would be a lot slower. So that's fun. And after these arena challenges, we're gonna get a Zony for completing one of them, and then the other one, we're actually gonna get a free upgrade to our bomb glove that's gonna make it much more powerful. And then after beating the fifth challenge, we're gonna get a new weapon, the Negotiator, which we're actually only gonna use a grand total of once in the entire game. And it's only gonna be in the next planet. So. Go up this elevator. Right here, I actually have to go to these stairs on the right, otherwise I'm gonna trigger a cutscene with a guy that I don't wanna talk to. So, you just go to the right there and you completely ignore him. So now we're going into the battle arena. Pull out Mr. Zircon and my bomb glove. So now, it begins. So I'm gonna throw these bomb gloves a little bit early to like make sure that they hit before the enemies are like fully spawned. I just sort of stand in the center to kill all the enemies. And as you can see, like, Mr. Zircon is shooting people while I'm not looking and focusing on other things. So that's why he helps out a lot. Like, you think you're, like, dealing with one group of enemies and Mr. Zircon is just, like, shooting the other group. So it's really useful. And it really helps out a lot. Oops. That guy's still alive. There's one guy over here. I have to kind of pay attention to my ammo here, too. I have to constantly be breaking these ammo boxes. Oh, oops. Yeah. Come on. Why is the shield guy's not... I'm running out of bomb glove ammo. Come on. Alright, so... Ammo management is kind of important. If you're running out of ammo, you should, like, go for ammo crates. But... sometimes that doesn't, like, it's not really possible because of a ton of enemies just surrounding you. So that was kind of a bad first challenge because of the ending there. Of the lack of ammo, but okay. I can deal with it. So this second challenge right here, you just stand in the middle and throw bombs at people. And the good thing about standing in the middle here is that you're right next to a constantly respawning ammo crate. So that you can just constantly keep getting more and more ammo if you're running low. Which is good. Come on, dude. Mr. Zircon exploded. And I have to make sure that I pull out Mr. Zircon again as soon as he, like, explodes. Oh, oops. No, nobody spawned there. I threw a bomb glove for, like, nothing. No, your bombs can't damage you. So it's no big deal. You can, like, shoot a bomb, like, at your feet. And you won't take any damage. In Crail Canyon, actually, the bomb that Azimuth used to blow up the wall so that we could escape the cave actually did do damage to me. Which is kind of funny. Azimuth actually ends up damaging you in that level. So the good thing about this challenge right here is that the game is, like, routed in such a way so that you actually get a health upgrade here. And the health upgrade, like I said, it does sort of this huge explosion thing that kills a bunch of stuff that's right next to you. And, oh, I actually didn't level up my health there. That's interesting. So, like, the health upgrade, it kills a bunch of enemies that are right next to you because it's this huge explosion. And it's really useful, like I said, on bosses, if you happen to get a health upgrade during your boss. But in the arena, it can also kind of speed you up. So this challenge is kind of different. You actually have to throw the bombs these guys throw at you back at them. So I have to kind of do it in a weird way. I have to pick up this guy's bomb, wait till he shoots another one, and then kill him, so that I already have a bomb prepped for the next guy. So that again, when he shoots one, I can just wait till he shoots one, then grab the one he shoots. So later on, these guys are gonna start coming up with shields, and I actually have to pull off the shields that they have. Oh, oops. Okay, so I accidentally killed that guy when I didn't really even mean to. That's okay. Okay, so as you can see, I got a health upgrade there, and I sort of did this huge wide explosion thing. Okay, so I wait for the guy with the shield to throw his bomb, then I throw it back at him, and there we go. That's the challenge. That was actually a really good challenge tree. Usually it doesn't go that well, mainly because the guys are like usually in bad positions. Alright, so now I got the Constructo mod for the bomb glove, and this upgrade, it gives me the shrapnel effect. So I'm immediately gonna pause, go to my inventory, customize the bomb glove, apply the shrapnel upgrade, and then we're all fine. So the shrapnel upgrade does a ton more damage than the regular bomb glove, and that's what I'm gonna be using to take out these guys up here. Alright, so I'm gonna wait till these guys like throw bombs. I can throw it back at them, so I don't have to constantly like be wasting bomb glove ammo. Okay, good. The guy shot a bomb before I killed him, so I can kill that guy without having to throw a bomb glove. And now we're on the last wave with plenty of ammo to spare, actually, which is good, because these guys with the spiked balls, they're kind of annoying. Ooh, that guy actually shot a ball at his own teammate. That's interesting. And the reason I pull out Mr. Zircon here is because oh, come on, really? Pull off the guy's shield. What the... Come on, okay. So, Mr. Zircon is dead. Where is he? Okay, there's that guy. So, that's the fourth challenge done. That was kind of a weird fourth challenge. Usually it doesn't go like that. So now we get a part for the Rhino 5, which is a weapon that we never get to see. And... Oh my god, really? Okay. I accidentally chose the wrong challenge. That's interesting. I accidentally chose the same challenge again instead of the last one. Right, that's what I meant to choose. So now we are at the final challenge. We're fighting enemies with Captain Quark, and it's three waves of enemies and then a boss fight. And the boss fight, I actually have to be kind of careful about, because I need to one cycle the boss, and one cycling it requires a pretty specific position, and I have need to have full, like, nearly full ammo to do it. So I have to kind of pay attention to my ammo count while I'm fighting these guys right here. So every time, like, a wave ends, I just get, like, more ammo. Oh my god, really? And I need to have Mr. Zircon out at all times so that he helps out. Alright, cool. Oh my god. Okay. So the guy was right there. That was kind of spooky. Alright, full ammo. Now we're on to the boss fight, and this boss is annoying. He can screw you over quite a bit. Okay. Oh, come on, Mr. Zircon. Come on, hit him! Okay, good. I one-cycled him. That's good. I almost missed that one-cycle, but I managed to pull it off at, the very last second. So that's cool. So now I just got the Negotiator, and it's a really powerful rocket launcher, but we're actually not going to use it at all, because it's just not worth it. It doesn't do nearly as much damage as our Bomb Glove does. I mean, it does do more damage than the Bomb Glove, actually, but it's not useful because it has a really slow rate of fire, and it just has way too, little ammo. There's only 8 shots on this thing, and the Bomb Glove has 15, or 12 at this point. So the bomb glove just has like way more ammo and way more reach, actually, on the rocket launcher. This is an okay Battleplex. Nothing really went wrong. Aside from me picking the wrong challenge on accident, but that was alright. Run killing glitches or skips? There are actually, but they're not gonna show up until the planet after this one. This is a pretty okay planet right now, which is Tumbly Outpost. There's gonna be a barrier skip here again, and it's possible for me to fail it if I do something wrong. Like, this barrier skip is kind of finicky, so let's hope I don't fail it, because this barrier skip likes to make you fail for sometimes for, like, literally no reason. So, the interesting thing is these satellites, they're blocking the planet. There's literally just a gap right here in between them, and you can just fly through it. There's really nothing there. You can just fly through it and land on the planet. It's interesting that they didn't bother to put anything there because it's out of bounds, and they didn't think anybody would go out of bounds there. That's just interesting. There's just nothing there. Yeah. It's not exactly run killing, but the next planet is quite difficult. And if I mess up a trick there, then I may or may not lose like 40 seconds. Which is kind of annoying. I won't die or anything, I'll just have to do a boss that I normally would skip. So. Alright, so right here at the start of Tumbly Outpost is actually a pretty difficult jump. I'm gonna see if I can get it. So, I use a negotiator here to align myself a little bit. This hyperstrike is annoying. Oh, okay, good. I actually didn't even have to hyperstrike there, I could just ledge grab. That jump is deceivingly harder than it looks, by the way. For some reason, there's like this weird oval, like invisible wall there around that platform, and sometimes if you try to hyperstrike there, you'll just get like bounced back really far and you'll die for no real reason. I don't really know why that happens, but it just does, so you gotta be kind of careful when you're doing that jump. There is an alternate method to do that. It's a lot safer, but it's quite a bit slower. So we talk to this guy, but then I'm bored of his talking. I don't care about him. So I just go over to this laser fence right here to activate a checkpoint. Otherwise, the game's gonna softlock later. So I need to go there to activate that checkpoint. And right here, the skip is stupid. Nope. Almost it. Okay, good. So I skipped that vine wall right there with that ledge grab. I'm gonna ledge grab this rock. And I'm gonna try to ledge grab this other rock from below here so that I can enter the security tower way early and I can deactivate the containment grid. And now that's the time portal, so I'm going to go to the past of this area. Tumbly Outpost 2 years ago, like it says. And, oh, I actually didn't end up skipping the cutscene, that's weird. So, I gotta talk to this guy right here. This is a mandatory, like, dialogue. And if I don't talk to this guy, I actually can't plant the vines here. So that, like, in the future, they'll grow so that I can ride the vines. And what's interesting is that I have to plant the vines here, but I will actually not ride the vines because there's a skip to skip doing that, but I have to plant them no matter what, even though I actually wanted even using them at all. Which is pretty stupid. Alright. So I just plant these free seeds. And now is a pretty difficult trick right here. I have to delay my jump off this ledge to get to the oil derrick without riding the vine. Please. Okay, good. Are there other languages where the talking is I actually haven't tested that, actually. I think, like, if I do change my PS3's language, that might, like, affect something. But, like, for this game, I don't think it would matter that much. But if it does, then I don't know. I have yet to test that. I don't think anybody's, like, messed around with that too much. That's an interesting point, though. I didn't even consider that until, like, right as you brought it up. Alright, so that strat over there is completely unnecessary. It saves only 2 seconds, and you can fail it and waste quite a lot of time. So now I have the oil for the Omni Soaker, so I can oil this winch crank right here and lower the bridge to this place. So this tower that I'm lowering the bridge to right here, you can actually glitch into it early. You can, like, seriously just, like, get in there. But you can actually get all the way to the end, and it will do nothing because you haven't hit all the triggers yet. This game is heavily trigger based. You can't just like skip ahead without completing the necessary requirements the game wants you to. So I got that double kill with the negotiator there. That's good. And now I'm gonna get more negotiator ammo here. And then I'm gonna kill this guy with my V2 negotiator. Oh, actually, I need to upgrade my V2 negotiator right here. I need to kill these guys. This is the only place in the game that we actually use the negotiator. We never use it anywhere else. Ooh, I missed that guy. Oh, come on. Yeah, changing the system language changes the language of the game. But I haven't even, like, messed around with it. It might actually, like, be faster because this is the PAL version of the game. Not the USA version, so it may actually be faster, but who knows. So that's Tombly Outpost. That was actually a kind of good fight at the end there. So now is Vorsalon 2, and basically the reason we're going to fight Vorsalon again is because Azimuth is a fucking idiot, and he got kidnapped, and now we gotta save him. But we're technically not even going to save him, actually. You're gonna see what we do there. Like I said, Azimuth's life in this game is just an endless cycle of disappointment and agony. So we're just not even gonna end up doing what he wants us to. We're not gonna fight Vorsalon, we are actually gonna leave him behind in the ship, and only use him when he's necessary to us. So, we just kinda screw over Azimuth throughout the entire game pretty much, especially at the end. We really screw over Azimuth really hard at the end. And you'll see that when we get there. So people who've beat this game, like, they know what I'm talking about already, so no real point in trying to foreshadow it, I guess. So, at Vorsalon's ship right here, I'm actually gonna buy my new weapon, which is the Groovitron Glove. It's gonna be very useful. It's basically just a disco ball that you throw, and every enemy in close to it starts dancing. And it's gonna be extremely useful in the late game. Like, the last sector, it's where it's extremely useful. But right now, it's not gonna be too useful, but I'm just gonna buy it right here since we can. Alright. So now we're gonna completely skip Vorsalon, hopefully anyways, by doing the skip. Hopefully I don't mess it up. Come on, please, please, okay. Alright. Apply myself. Then I just hyperstrike over here. Do another jump. And I get to this huge circle area. And then I do a slope intercept with my hover boots on. Go around this thing, into this door, into this room right here. And now this is the gravity ramp zip, which is really, really stupid, and I don't like it. So. Oh, oops. Messed it up. Oh, come on, really? Wow, really? Okay, I think I'm getting the angle wrong. I'm doing this, like, really wrong. Please. Okay, good, 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 good. That's good. That's good. That's actually good. No! Wait, shit! Ah, no, are you kidding me? Oh, wait. What? Oh, no! I did it. Okay, good, good. That's actually really good. So, I thought that I had failed that skip right there, but I actually did get it, so... That was really scary. So what I was trying to do there is, I was trying to skip Vorsalon, which, involves getting proxied up in that room, but sometimes you can get, proxied back down into Vorsalon's room, but thankfully I landed above his arena and didn't trigger the fight, and so I was able to completely skip him. So, taking damage from those lasers in that hallway right there was actually good. Because I'm gonna death warp here shortly. Alright. So, as you saw, Azimuth being held like captive there, and we gotta destroy these generators to save him or whatever, but we don't really care about Azimuth. So, we're just gonna destroy the generators and then we're gonna leave him behind because we're cool like that. Oh, come on, please. Gonna destroy this other generator in Death Warp 2. And then, we're gonna get to the last generator. And then, save Azimuth, quote unquote. So here you need the Omni Soaker to fill up water, but we don't actually need it. That's good. That's the last generator, and now Azimuth is freed. But the thing about freeing Azimuth is, we're actually not gonna let him go with us. We're gonna abandon him completely by, you'll see what I mean. So, there you go, Azimuth is freed. And now, we gotta escape the ship. And escaping the ship is actually leaving the ship without Azimuth. So, I'm in the Vorsalon's arena here. And I'm killing enemies, and because I because the elevator closed on him, but now, what we're gonna do instead. Because we need him to operate this turret, we're just gonna activate the hangar checkpoint and then die. So we just briefly abandon Azimuth there. Hey username, what's up? Audio? What happened to the audio? What happened? Oh, okay. Alright, that's good. I thought there was something like with my stream, because I saw that OBS started dropping frames. I saw like 65 frames. Missile, so I'm just gonna kill him there. Alright. Yeah, I saw OBS as like, the bit rate Okay, so, oh crap, what the fuck is going on with OBS right now? Holy shit. So, is it back now? Is it back now? 960 dropped frames. Thanks, OBS. Okay. Please tell me it's good now. Please tell me like the audio is decent now. Okay, good. Yeah, OBS is... OBS is like having a stroke, I think. Like, I just keep like dropping frames a bunch. That's weird. Alright. And there we go. Reset OBS? No, I'm not gonna reset OBS. I did that for the other marathon, it actually took a while to go back. So this cutscene right here, in the Great Clock, I actually have to skip it, otherwise I'm gonna start the Clank level. And that's really not good. So when you're running this game, you gotta be careful to not just like walk away. When you're doing this Clank skip, otherwise you're actually gonna lose like a ton of time. It's pretty much a reset. If you like fail a Clank skip, and you have to do a Clank level, just reset. There's no point. But thankfully they're pretty easy, so there's like no risk of messing them up. Alright. That's the last time we have to watch one of these intermissions. And now we're on to the final sector of the game. And as soon as we get to the final sector, we have one of the hardest tricks in the entire game. Actually, hold on, let me close the door because people can't shut the fuck up. Alright, so we're gonna rewarp to the Bernelia sector and onto the hardest trick in the entire game, Valkyrie Citadel Skip, in my opinion. Basically, we find out that Clank is being held hostage in Valkyrie Citadel. Or, actually, he gets kidnapped after this cutscene, and we have to go rescue him in Valkyrie Citadel. But we don't actually have to go there because of a jump in Nefarious Station that gets us to the platform that you're normally supposed to get after Valkyrie Citadel. So let me explain it. Like, after Valkyrie Citadel, a couple of slingshot targets show up so that you can get to a platform and then get to Quark, and then enter the Nefarious Station. But you can just actually jump to that platform with a very precise double jump and a hyper strike. And so that completely skips going to Valkyrie Citadel. It saves a ton of time, but it's extremely difficult. The jump is very, very hard, and I don't know if I'll be able to get it first try or second try, because it's a really, really hard jump. In my world record yesterday, I actually did manage to get it first try, which is a really rare occurrence. I usually never get it first try. But I think after enough like practice today, I got the muscle memory down, I think. So hopefully I shouldn't fuck it up. Hopefully, anyways. So Clank gets kidnapped here. So now we have the lovely Nurse Shannon, actually. So, if you can kindly appreciate the godly visage that you will see in a moment. Right here. Just look at that, man. Isn't that great? Right. Had to open the door for the dog to go back. So now we're gonna do the last barrier skip in the game. And it's actually kinda difficult. Yeah, dude, Nurse Shannon. So these satellites right here, they can actually shoot me. And if I get shot at them for too much, if I get shot at them too many times, then I'm actually gonna die. Right. And now we're at Nefarious Station early. So, now is Valkyrie Citadel skip, which is, in my opinion, the hardest skip in the entire game. Like, I don't think there's anything in this game that's harder than this. Because, like, when you get here, you're usually, like, on a good run. So, when you get to this trick, you're like, oh god, please don't fuck it up, please don't fuck it up. And you end up fucking it up, because you're too nervous about fucking it up. So, I don't know, I just gotta, like, focus for this, because it's pretty hard. And I don't wanna fuck it up. Because I think this run is actually on somewhat decent pace. And I wanna... Yeah, you can skip all of them. I did that for the other two barriers as well. Alright, so this skip. Please, okay, good, first try, that's really good. Oh my god, okay. That's a fucking sigh of relief right there, holy shit. Wow. Okay. So now that that's over with, we're going to something that's equally as hard, Nefarious Station, the interior. And I'll explain Nefarious Station when we get there. So, that's Valkyrie Citadel skip. That's much harder than it looks, by the way. I made it look easy. That's extremely difficult. Now we have the rendezvous with Nurse Shannon, and now we're gonna crash Nefarious' party. We're gonna invade a space station. If the game loads the cutscene, that is. I said if the game doesn't take 5 years to load the cutscene, thank you. Alright. Now we're at the Nefarious Space Station, the interior part of it. And this is what can make or break your run after Valkyrie Citadel skip. Because this... this is not fun. It's... 3 very hard skips, all in a row, with no breaks in between, and you can't fuck him up. So Nurse Shannon is helping us out by blocking this trash compactor and just stare at this godly visage for a bit. Just look at it. Just look at it, dude. Isn't that great? Isn't that so amazingly? Isn't that the best thing you've ever seen in your entire life? Just look at this. Just look at that. It's all over now. Alright, Nurse Shannon is dead. Now we're gonna invade Nefarious Station. And by invade, I mean we're not gonna kill anything, and we're actually just gonna skip all of it. So this first trick is annoying and hard and stupid and random and dumb. So, let's see if I get it. Oh god. Come on. Please, okay. Robot, can you please get over here? Where the... Robot, what the fuck? Okay, these robots, I need them to be in this spot right here so that I can use them. Come on. Hey, asshole, come back here. I'm trying to do a speed run. What are you doing? Just come back. Alright. Come on, are you fucking serious? Jesus, alright. Come on, fucking... Hey, you, come on. Come on, where is he? Where is he, dude? Okay, fucking finally, okay. God damn. So, that robot likes to screw me over a lot. That's the second skip, really easy. And now I'm gonna throw out a Groovitron here to give it a little bit of experience as well. And to make sure these robots don't kill me while I'm trying to do this skip. Alright. Then I aim over here, line myself, and then hyperstrike over here. Oh shit, okay, where am I? Okay, good. No, are you kidding me? I got sniped, and now I have to do all of that all over again. No, okay, world record is dead. If there was any, like, slim chance that this could be, like, a world record run, all of that is dead now. Sorry. Sorry to, like, kill everybody's dreams, but, yeah. Ugh, that's so stupid. I can't believe that, dude. This is the worst space station I've ever had. Okay, whatever. Come on, what the fuck? Why, dude? Come on, let me jump off the fucking robot and I don't even grab the ledge. Come on. Hey, asshole, come back here. Thank you. And you please. Come on. Jesus Christ. Jumping off of these robots is much harder than it was in Vorcelon 1. And 2 hits from these robots will kill me. Come on. Ah. Oh, Jesus. Oh, good lord. What the fuck am I doing? This is the worst space station ever. If I don't get this soon enough, I might as well just like kill the robots normally. Cause this is too much. Alright. If you die here, the second laser barrier deloads, so that's cool, I guess, but... whatever, dude. Can't believe it. I got hit by the robot, like, once. And then I got hit by that big guy's, like, bullet, and that killed me. That's so dumb. That was actually a good space station up until now. If it wasn't for that guy that shot me, that would have been actually a really good space station. But no, every time I'm on a run with good pace, I gotta fucking kill it to some dumb bullshit. Cause, you know, can't have a world record pace in running marathon. Gotta fuck it up to Nefarious Station of all things. Not even Valkyrie Citadel skip, just Nefarious Station. That's embarrassing. Alright, whatever. Now we're disguised as Nefarious and Lawrence is doing shit, I guess. Alright, so because we skipped so much stuff, Quark actually isn't fast enough to get on this elevator. We just leave him behind. Got it. How do I do that? I'm not 100% on that one, but I'm sure you'll think of something. Just remember, keep it on the loose. Alright, so that was absolutely horrible, but who cares? Not like I was really like expecting world record with this run or anything. So we kill these two guys here as Nefarious because it's just faster to kill them here. Instead of killing normally. Because we actually are gonna have to fight all the guys in this room. Have Dale or Shovel Chin. It does have Shovel Chin. It has Mini Chin too. Yeah, Quark just gets left behind because he sucks. Nobody really cares about Quark at this point. Guess that's 4 rocks or 5, I don't know. Alright. Alright. Yeah, if you pass by those robots, they can actually say like, hey, he looks shorter. They actually notice that Nefarious looks different, which is cool. Alright, now we have to fight all the guys in this room as Nefarious, so yeah, Nefarious is just blowing up his own guys right here. And this is actually an unlockable skin in New Game Plus. You can play the entire game as Nefarious if you want to, which is really good. Come on. Okay, that was a double kill. That's good. Come on, dude. Please? Please? Please, just die. Now I'm gonna throw out a Groovitron here to keep this big guy from fucking over my life. As well as all the little guys. Oh shit, I need ammo, actually. I ran out of bomb glove ammo. Yeah, okay, that's good. So, this guy or two right here. Where's the other guy? There's these two guys right here. Come on, dude. Okay. So that's the fight over with. And now that's Nefarious Station done. So Yeah, unfortunately. It's just a skin. This is actually, like, the only place where you can actually, like, save things as Nefarious. Alright. That was an absolutely horrible space station. I got first try Valkyrie Citadel skip, but then I immediately threw that in the fucking garbage by dying twice. Or three times, actually, by doing those skips. So, that was much worse than it needed to be. Alright, so the next level is Gimlik Valley. Or, actually, Gimlik Valley. And, that's where we buy the Buzz Blades, and it's the last weapon we get in the game. And they're actually really overpowered when they have, high levels. And there's actually a route that I recently devised to get them to level 4 in Gimlik Valley. So that's cool, I guess. This is actually one of the longest cutscenes in the game, this one right here, before Gimlik Valley. It's like 3 minutes or something. It's really long. It's unnecessarily, like, stupid. You're just sort of hearing Nefarious' life story, I guess. Oh yeah, Clank shows up out of nowhere here because, we're supposed to save him in Valkyrie Citadel skip, and we're supposed to have him for Nefarious Station. Like, I'm not supposed to be doing Nefarious Station as Ratchet solo. Clank is supposed to be with us there, but because I skipped Valkyrie Citadel, he's actually not. The game actually is kind enough to give us Clank when we load in Gimlik Valley, so we don't actually have to go rescue Clank. We can just use him because the game gives him to us. Yeah, reminder to spam Shovel Chin right now.
How do you like my asteroid flinger 5000? I had it installed in the event I ever needed a super ironic death scenario.
Nefarious, you're making a mistake.
Time will tell. Bon voyage, my old nemesis.
Right, so now we're in Gimlik Valley, the second to last planet in the game.
Ratchet, we do not have a lot of time. Destroying the Armada will not keep Nefarious away.
Nah, popping a cap in their heads would be too easy. And you know, we still have, like, more gameplay. If he just killed them right there, then, you know, there would be no game. Alright. Now we buy the Buzz Blades, and the Buzz Blades are actually really fucking loud. So, apologies, because the Buzz Blades are actually really loud. Right, now we're gonna kill these two guys right here from afar with my Buzz Blades. Because it's just faster to do it. It gives us more experience. And now that we have that experience for the Buzz Blades, we're just gonna go over here and continue with the level. We're gonna throw a Groovitron over here, so these guys drop their shields and start dancing. And killing them too for more Buzz Blade experience. I'm gonna kill these guys over here for more Buzz Blade XP too. Oh, I actually killed that guy that was riding the thing. That was interesting. So, I suddenly killed that guy. That gives my boss weight a little more experience. And now they're at V3. And you're gonna be close to V4. Which is what I want. I want them to be at V4. So now I gotta fight these two Hydra tanks. And I'm gonna use my buzzblades to level them up a little bit on the Hydra tanks. Because they actually do slowly gain levels when I'm using them here. So right here I'm gonna drop another Groovitron. So these guys that are coming towards me start dancing as well. I'm gonna kill these guys too, so they don't cause any problems. I'm gonna use my buzz blades on the Hydra tank as well. Oh, come on, grab the thing. And now I use the buzz blades on the Hydra tank till they're at V4. And now, since they're at V4, I can just use my bomb glove. There we go. And now I don't even have to worry about leveling up the buzzblades anymore, since I can just use my bomb glove on the Hydra tank to kill them faster. I'm actually gonna pull out Mr. Zircon here, because he helps out with these guys. And we're gonna kill the rest of this Hydra tank. There we go, and now we get to plant the seeds to ride the vine. This time we actually have to ride the vine, unlike in Tomley Outpost where I can just skip doing it. So we have to plant these three seeds. And as you can see, Clank is actually on our back now, so that's neat. Those guys are still alive? Wow. So yeah, Clank is with us now, so that's cool. Oh man, it's almost 3 p.m. I'm really fucking hungry. Damn, I'm gonna finish this run as fast as possible so I can fucking eat. I haven't eaten anything since like 11. Alright, so we're riding the vine. And now we gotta fight this guy. So, this guy is the prime example of why buzz waves are super, like, OP. Especially for flying enemies. I can use time bombs. Oh no, wait, I can't even. Oh, that's interesting. Because, actually, like, when I complete the game and I, like, reload the file with Clank, I actually can use time bombs, so that's interesting. I thought that you could, because, when I reloaded, like, the file post-game, I always, like, could use time bombs. Oh, never knew that. It's interesting to point out. I killed these guys with the buzz blades like instantly. And now this guy comes back. And then he's dead. There we go. Now we gotta toss these battery bots into their pods or whatever. And now... that's it. And now that's it. Gimlick Valley is done with. And now, we're going to the final two bosses. It's Nefarious, and then the final boss. And I bet you guys can't guess who the final boss will be. It's not Nefarious. Anybody who's beaten this game knows what I'm talking about already, so... Why do I even, like, say that? So, yeah. The Groovitron and the Buzzblades are, like, the main weapons we're gonna use against the two final bosses. Which is why we buy them in the first place. You could technically go Bomb Glove only, but it's not recommended at all. Because Nefarious keeps flying through most of his battle, so like using a throwing weapon for a flying boss is really annoying. Carlton Danks, yeah, it's actually Carlton Danks. We're gonna fight him. Is it Drek? No. Drek is dead, like... He dies in the first game, I think. Alright. Ratchet, Pensive Blair, Proto Pet, nah. Yeah, you guys are actually gonna get, I think, surprised by the final boss. The huge reveal of the final boss. It's actually quite shocking. Alright. Now we're gonna jump to Nefarious' platform instead of going the long way around. Nefarious from Up Your Arsenal, nah. Then we just climb up this post and then jump off in this direction and activate the fight. So now, Nefarious. He's the second to last boss. And he's pretty annoying. Have to use Mr. Zircon and the Buzzblades a lot. So, immediately right here I'm gonna pause, go to Control Options, and go to Default. So, in Default, I don't have to manually aim, my Buzzblades all just lock onto him. And that's actually really good, because I don't want any of them to miss, and I want to deal as much damage to him as humanly possible. Okay, he's dead. Nope. Nobody spoil it. Nobody, like, spoil it what the final boss is. I want to see the reaction to it after this fight. It's gonna be pretty amazing, not gonna lie. Alright. So, that was the first phase of Nefarious done. Lawrence? No, nobody spoil the final boss. I want to see how people react to it. It's going to be pretty amazing. Mrs. Zircon? No. Just take a wild guess. Oh no, I fucked up. Alright, so I fucked up. I didn't throw the Groovitron when I should have. And now, I threw the Groovitron in, like, the wrong place. So he summons these UFOs, which is not supposed to happen. Cratchit's daddy. It's definitely Nurse. Yeah, dude, Nurse Shannon is actually the final boss. No, just kidding. Nurse Shannon. Yeah, dude. That godlike pectoral region is literally impossible to hit. Ooh, Mr. Zircon is actually at level 5. I didn't even notice that. That's gonna help a lot in the second phase. Or in the third phase right here. Yeah, it's Nurse Shannon. My boy, the Rixer here, can confirm that Nurse Shannon is actually the final boss. Oh my god, please no. Okay. That was kind of scary. Oh, Oh my god, no! What the fuck? No, I hate this game. I hate this game. Okay, that wasn't my fault, okay? The game just misaligned me there. Oh my fucking god. Really? Really? What the fuck? Okay, so what happened there was, I was slightly off center. I was slightly, like, misangled. And Ratchet just had, like, a seizure. And the game didn't know what to do. So it just fucking threw me into the pit. Since that's what happens when... And oh my god, I almost died again right there. I'm at 3 health. Holy shit. How am I gonna do Nefarious Phase 3 with 3 health? Oh no. Oh, Jesus Christ. Yeah, this was actually a good run at first, but then everything started going to shit. Wait, what? Picnic? No, it's not a picnic. And I just died again because I'm very smart. Great. Alright, so this run is a train wreck. Nothing can save this run. So this is gonna be like a 120 something in game time, whatever, I don't really care. That's okay. Right. Oh god. These peanuts taste a little salty. Neither of the next runners are responding right now, okay. I can take as long as I want. What was my estimate for this? Like 215? 220? Was it 220? I don't even know. I don't even remember. Was it 215? Was it? I don't fucking remember. Alright. So, now Lawrence is gonna activate the autopilot, which is gonna activate this laser. And what's gonna happen is, I'm actually gonna manipulate Lawrence to shoot the laser at Nefarious so that it hurts him. So that Nefarious actually gets hurt by the laser. And that actually takes off a ton of health from him. It doesn't seem like it, but... Yeah, that just took off like a ton of health. So now Nefarious is dead. And now we have the final cutscene revealing the true final boss. So, get ready for the big reveal here. I'm actually gonna mute my mic so you guys can be flabbergasted at the reveal here.
So, I can't talk you out of this, can I? Ratchet, we have been on many adventures, but the clock needs someone to protect it. It is what I was built for.
Wait, so that's it? What about the Lombaxes?
They're not in danger. They've just moved on. And we'll find them. But the past stays where it is. Come on, pal. I'll walk you in. You were never a sidekick. You do know that, right?
I always thought that you were the sidekick.
Where are you going? This is your responsibility. You can't just walk away. The Lombaxes need us. Don't walk away from me. I said stop!
Yup, Azimuth is the final boss. He kills Ratchet, and now we gotta run away. In case nobody knew that already. So, yeah. But once we enter this chamber, Clank is gonna turn back time to save Ratchet. So that's alright. Right, so we gotta fight Azimuth now as Ratchet. That's pretty cool. Ouch, that hurt. So now we gotta chase after him and kill his Lombax, but I guess. So the strat that we use for Azimuth is actually that. Oh my, what? What the fuck even happened? Okay. the thing despawned. That's cool. Yeah, thanks Azimuth. Thanks. Like fucking great. Alright, so who cares? So we're gonna kill Azimuth now by stunning him with the Groovitron and wrecking him with the Buzz Blades. So, yeah. Nice strat. Yeah, I don't know what happened there. I've never seen that happen. Ratchet and Clank New Game Plus 90% is 23:43. Yeah, I'm actually like 2 hours behind the world record, guys. Sorry. I didn't mean it to be this way. So, yeah, we gotta kill Azimuth. And the strat we use for him is pretty stupid. We're gonna make him dance for us. He's gonna dance all night long, baby. So, throw out a Groovitron, throw out Mrs. Zircon. And then it's just Buzz Blades from here. This is the entire fight, by the way. We're just keeping stunned. And then just keep shooting him with Buzz Blades. So I'm moving closer and farther away from him because the Buzz Blades do more damage. That's just the nature of how they work. And then I'm moving back because I need to get ammo. So yeah, this is pretty much the Azimuth fight. We just keep him dancing and keep wrecking him with Buzz Blades. Yeah, so Azimuth is gonna dance for us again. And he's just gonna keep dancing all night long into the night. And there he is, dancing his heart away. Look at that, look at that disco dance. Look at that Michael Jackson moonwalk. I mean, he just killed Ratchet and tried to destroy the universe, but you know, who cares, he has good dance moves, man. Just look at that groove, man, that's some godly dancing skills. I mean, just look at that, man. Alright, get ready on the timer, by the way, Milk. It's coming up. And time. It's over. That's it. It's over. Oh, hey. That was actually not as bad as I thought it would be. Alright, let's see the in-game time. Let's see what time we got in-game. Yeah, not even sub 2. What a fucking disgrace. Right. Check this in-game timer real quick. Oh yeah, I have to listen to this asshole talk for like... Yeah, okay. No, it's okay. I just forget that fucking Vorslon here doesn't shut up. Alright. Yeah, Azimuth dies. Like, we don't even just, like, defeat him. He actually, like, dies in the story. I just skipped the cutscene where it shows him dying. Right. Voice Salon says a bunch of shit that I don't care about. So let's check the in-game timer. And no, this is not a world record. This was a 122.38. That was better than my 123.42, which was my old PB. So, yeah, it was alright. So yeah, that's a cracking time. Thank you all for watching this train wreck of a disaster, but hey, it was fun. But now I'm hungry as shit and I want some food, so yeah. Goodbye. Nah, no problem. Thanks for hosting this marathon for degenerate homos. So, yeah, thanks. Yeah.